Oh, good morning, everyone. And today, here I am discussing about the composition and nutritional value of the food. This is the first lecture of this course, Food Chemistry. So first of all, what is the food and why it is important? And where it is derived, and what is the major constituents in the food, what is the basic functions. So first of all, in the food, for every organism, the essential for life, and they have derived from plants and animals or any other single cell organisms. So that provides nutrient substance that people are eating, drink, or order to maintain lives. So the important point of view, the food provides the energy for the all body functions and the new cells formations, or for maintaining the other physiological functions, and any organisms taken by foods according to on the test of availability of the foods. Availability of the food, taste of foods, body requirements. So sometimes क्या होता है कि हमारे पास availability है उसके according to हम लोग choice करते हैं food का. Sometimes में क्या है कि हमारा जो body का demand क्या है उसके according to हम लोग करते हैं. और कभी कभी होता क्या है कि हमें हम लोग taste के लिए करते हैं. जैसे कि हमें कोई ऐसा taste चाहिए, हमें अच्छा लग रहा है, मीठा लग रहा है, खट्टा लग रहा है, तो according to taste भी. So So overall, the consumption of the food or food is taken by any organisms depend upon taste, requirements, and availability. And the main functions of the foods is necessary for building materials, energy building materials, and protective materials. So some parts of the food, such like the polysaccharides, are not directly used for the production of energy, but it is not ki ha iska use nahi hai, iska upyog nahi hai, ya fir iska kya bol sakte hain, ye kisi activity mein participate nahi karta hai. Iska role hai in the gastrointestinal tract during the process of digestion. So it is also called dietary it is also like the dietary fiber. So many others major nutrients ke alawa, so many major nutrients minor component originally present in raw material, and they are the very essentials like the vitamins and minerals. So as sometimes most of the free amino acids and the other components, the very a small quantity present in the food, the impacts on the sensory properties of the food, such like storage, such like the sensation, jaise ki bahut sare aise compounds, jaise vitamins hai, vitamins A hai, they helps in sensations, eye, matlab increasing the vision of eye, aur bhi hai bahut sara sensation, jaise bahut sara minerals hai jo kaam karta hai sensations mein. So many compounds, some other compounds added during process according to need, such like the preservatives, antioxidants, colors, flavoring, sweeteners, and emulsifying agents for improving the quality of the foods. Improving some other groups such like tocopherol, carotenoids, and ascorbic acid, thiosamine, and several other non-nitrogenous proteinaceous compounds such as the endogenous muscle antioxidants. So sometimes if we have been studying the food for the long time for enhancing the shelf life by adding the preservation, but sometimes you have the adding the antioxidant for the purpose for reduction of the oxidation. Sometimes some people demanding ya fir hum bol sakte hain ki the demand of the food, these colors is the more attractive, so you adding the colors for enhancing the colors, and the sometimes flavors and sometimes sweetness. So according to need, according to demands, and according to and the availability of the foods you during processing, you adding the some quantity of the minor food components or nutrients. So classifications, so overall the nutrients are the classified into major groups: the water, carbohydrate, fat, protein, minerals and vitamins. So overall the classified into two groups: the micronutrients and macronutrients. The macronutrients in this groups includes carbohydrate, fats and the proteins and waters, and the micronutrients including this groups the major minerals and vitamins. Micronutrient or micronutrients are classified basis of the requirements, but the some other compounds present in the minor quantity: non-nitrogenous compounds, colorants, flavor compounds, flavor compound, functional additives. These have the significant effect on the quantity of the food products. So the some source of the foods and the nutrient composition, some source of the foods and the nutrient composition. Here examples of with the sources of the waters: these fruits are the major source of the water, these food items are the major source of the carbohydrate, the protein, the soybeans, these meats are the source of the protein, the lipids, while chocolates are the lipid source, the mineral source, the vegetable fruits and meats and dairy products, and vitamins are the fish liver, meat, cereals, milks, vegetables are the vitamin source. So these are the examples of the food components sources where you can measure proportions of these nutrients compounds are present. So the comes on the main functions that the necessary building materials such like the polysaccharides, proteins and lipids as the acts as a building material of the different structure of the plants and the animal tissue. So these nutrients are the responsible for the tensile strength of the tissue and the shape forming and they create a necessary condition for providing the all metabolic process. So the overall sense that these necessary building materials are not only for the shaping and the tensile strength, but also they play a biological role in the organisms. So these main component of the constituents, the sum of the other constituents bound to the different cell structure and disturbing the stable for the tissue and the fluids in the minor quantity. So energy yielding materials, the carbohydrate, proteins and the fats are the energy yielding materials, but the overall for the consumption of the human points of the view, the carbohydrate is the more efficient source of the energy. It is not the proteins and fats like more efficiently utilized for the purpose of the energy, because the carbohydrate is easily digested and absorbed and applied for the producing the energy. So and the some other source of the carbohydrates like the starch and granules and the cereals are not much more produce energy because it's not digested and absorbs. So and the protein fats are the also are the source of the energy producing material, but not like the carbohydrates. Fats gives the more energy per grams units as compared to carbohydrate and protein, but it is not efficiently utilized or easily digested as compared to carbohydrate. So the better to use the for the energy purpose the carbohydrate used. The protective functions, the many of the minor compounds present foods are nutritionally essential, such as vitamins and minerals as the main function in the protective function. The other functions in the foods, such like minerals and vitamins, utilized for the sensory properties of the food products. such as the other compounds, the tocopherol, carotenoids, ascorbic acids, thiamines, and several other non-nitrogenous compounds, such as the endogenous muscle antioxidants, play essential role in the postmortem change during the food. The some other compounds and during storing and after the storage and the postmortem change during the meats and the muscles, that time he has play a crucial role for the maintaining and the shelf life. And the some compounds and the minor components are harmless or even harmful are harmful if present. Some other compounds and the water is a very important nutrient and present in the foods in the very less quantity to the much more 90% of the many fruits and the vegetables. And he has played an important crucial role for the metabolic activity, they are bound and they are bound to the food and some nutrients, and they are found in the free form. So the contribution and maintenance and the conformation of the polymers, the waters play an important role, and they interact with other metabolic process, and the important parts of the physiological process, they play a crucial role. These are the examples of the some food items. They constitute the water percentage up to 86.8%. This is not fixed, sometimes the 90%. And here you see the milk content 86.8% water content, but here grains and cereals are the 15% and 12%. So here you see the cereals, grains, the less water compared to milk. So you have the storage facility according to the water availability in the food items. You have the less water contents. We have stored two long periods as compared to water content is more. And the next class I will discussing about the water content and water activity about water level you affecting. So carbohydrates. Carbohydrate is widely distributed plants and animal tissue. It found commonly in the form of the starch, glucose, fructose, and lactose. So the function, the main function, the utilization of the energy. So it also serves as the carbon skeletals of the synthesis of the various compounds, and also provide the tissue fluid and perform the different biological functions. Some polysaccharides not partially utilized for the energy purpose. And these are the examples of the food items that contain the carbohydrate percentage. Sagri 94.95%, honey 79-80%, sago 87%. Here you see the some fruits and vegetable mix, the less content of the carbohydrate as compared to honey, sago, sagri. So you choose according to demand of the nutrient of the foods. You need the carbohydrate to select the food items, can sugar, sago. You do not want to more carbohydrate, you choose the fresh waters, milks, nuts, and wild seeds. So depending on your requirements, you can choose the food items, what is your demand or body, or what is your choice. The next is the protein content. The protein content in the food is the present mainly as the form of the crude proteins, because you have the estimating the protein in the as the nitrogen content is estimative. The nitrogen content for the protein in the protein about 60%. So the nitrogen content in their protein is 60%. The factor is 6.25. The factors, that means the 60% are 100 by 16 is equal to 6.25. So you have to estimating the protein in the form of nitrogen to multiply factor 6.25 gives the nitrogen percentage. The nitrogen content in the protein in the various foods that depend upon the amino acid component of the protein content. So the sometimes three peptides, amino acid, and nucleic acids are present. So the non-protein nitrogen constituents up to 30%, 30% not more nitrogen content. So you have to calculating the protein that times not give the nitrogen quantity to overall protein. So multiplying the factor 6.25, because the some non-nitrogenous parts are also and nutrients are also present. The protein foods presents in the two forms, either animal origin or vegetable origin. These are the examples of the protein source. The lipids. Lipids are the naturally occurring compounds, substance. They are insoluble in water, soluble in organic solvents. Their source is the plants or animal. This classifies into lipids, compound lipids, simple lipid, compound lipid, and dry lipid. The functions, the main function is the source of energy. They provide also essential fatty acids, the source of the fat soluble vitamin, and it is also serves as insulating subcutaneous tissues, and also parts of the vital organs. It provides the material percentage of cholesterol and other steroid hormones. It is also a constituent part of the lipoprotein and glycoprotein for essential maintaining the cellular integrity, and also essential for maintaining the good health. These are the examples of the fats sources that contain the percentage of the fat. Here you see the butter 85% lipids, but in the rice is 2% and the lean fish is 1%. So this is an important source, protein. So less quantity of the lipid. These are the source of the fatty acids, and the fatty acids are classified into two groups: saturated and unsaturated. Saturated, here not a double bond present. Here the double bonds are present. Double bond either 1, 2, or 3. अगर एक होगा तो उसको मोनो अनसैचुरेटेड, एंड दो होगा तो पॉली अनसैचुरेटेड, एंड फूफा 3 more than 2 इज द हाईली अनसैचुरेटेड फैटी एसिड. सो द पॉली और फूफा कंसिडरेड समटाइम्स सेम ग्रुप्स और द डिफरेंट ग्रुप्स. सो डिपेंड अपॉन द प्रेजेंस ऑफ द डबल बॉन्ड्स दे आर क्लासिफाइड इनटू मोनो अनसैचुरेटेड, पॉली अनसैचुरेटेड और हाईली अनसैचुरेटेड फैटी एसिड. And these are the examples and the source of the saturated and unsaturated fatty acids. So the minerals they require the body is the very essential and small amounts. It is important parts of the important parts and the parts of the body for the basic growth and structure. So about 25 minerals are essential for the life present in the body. They are classified into two groups: major minerals and the trace elements. The major elements in the calcium, phosphorus, calcium, sodium, potassium, chlorides, and the trace minerals, the minor minerals sometimes classified iodine, zinc, selenium, chromium, and copper. The source of the minerals: egg, meats, milk, nuts, vegetables. They are the major source. Milk is also major source of the minerals such like the calcium and the phosphorus. And the mineral, there are 60 minerals for the human body need in order to maintain the function properly. And the some important functions such like the formation of the teeth, hemoglobin, bones, thyroid hormone, component of the hair, nails, and cell integrity. And the mineral content of the edible portions of the fish, the so many important minerals like calcium, phosphorus, iron, and copper are present in the fish, and also seeds of the iodine. Most of the shellfish are the especially rich of the calcium, magnesium, copper, zinc, and iodine. The vitamins. Vitamins, the similar likes of the minerals, require the very less quantity, but they are very important. He has provides so many vital functions, and also supporting and helps the utilization of the major nutrients to our body. So they are essential for the health. And they are classified in the two groups, depending upon the solubility. The one is the water soluble, one is the fat soluble. The water soluble, example, the vitamin B and C, and the fat soluble vitamin A, D, E, K. The functions, the most of the B enzymes, vitamin B, are the essential component of the specific coenzymes. They participating in the energy metabolism and the specialized activities. So vitamin regulates the body process such energy production. So the during the energy production, they are act as the activators for activating and regulating the enzyme activity. And also helps in the blood clotting, calcium balance. Vitamins helps to maintaining that organ and tissue healthy. The source. What is the source of the vitamins? Vitamins are found in the fruit, vegetable, grains, legumes, meats, fish, and the dairy products. So, micronutrients, the vitamins and minerals are essentials, but required very less quantity. They are participating directly or indirectly in the other metabolic activities. And the source of fish as a source of the vitamin, the vitamin A, D, E source fish. And the reported 30,000 international IU, that means the 30,000 international unit per gram, and vitamin D 250,000 international unit per gram. The liver has been found in the some cases. The vitamin A D is a resource, fish liver wire, richest source. The fish wire, liver wire is the used for the so many medical medicinal purpose. Factor affecting the composition of the food. So many factors that affect the composition of the food, and such like the different component of food raw material depend upon the species. What is the species? What is the variety of the species? And also affect on the age. and harvestings of the plants. This is you have harvesting that depend the nutrient questions and the and other minor and major nutrients on the feeding conditions. What is the feeding condition and what is the age of farm animals, seasons, and what is the condition, environmental condition where the food item survives. Examples in the fish, the fresh water and marine water, they different the nutrient composition because their environmental condition is different. The salty water marines and the fresh water, there is not salt present. Processed foods and the processed foods, they depend upon the processing, whatever processing methods, how to proceed, that depends and the nutrient quality and the, what is the storage facility, they also affect the nutrient compositions. So during processing, we have to cooking, sometimes you have washing, sometimes you have thawing, sometimes we have evaporation, sublimations. They all the processing methods that affect the nutrient compositions. We have sometimes we have the heating at the high temperatures, they affect and deteriorate, they affect and damage the nutrient contents, leaching. So processing methods is a very important aspect of the nutrient composition point of the feed. The enzymatic activity, sometimes the enzymatic activity also produce the harmful compound they affect. So sometimes some other compounds produced during storing that affect the quality of the nutrient. The loss of nutrient and deterioration by fly and mats and beetles affects the composition of the food. So you have to considering and keep in mind during processing. What is the process you adapted? What is the process during the processing that affects the nutrient constituents? During a storage, you have not restored the proper place. You have not providing the proper facility of the storing facility. They also affect the nutrient constituents and nutrient quality. So, keeping on mind for setting the nutrient quality and nutrient quantity, if you stored or properly. So okay, we have any questions, you can ask.